हेलो
हेलो मैम।
आवाज आ रही है ना मेरी?
यस मैम।
स्क्रीन दिख रही है सबको?
यस मैम।
ओके गुड। बाकी के लोग कहाँ है? सिर्फ 21 पार्टिसिपेंट। टेल योर फ्रेंड्स टू जॉइन फास्ट। Shall we start the session?
यस मैम।
गुड। सब जगे हुए हो ना? यस और नो?
मैम आवाज खूब स्लो है तो है।
ओके आता?
हाँ बरोबर है।
इतना आता? ओके। सो today's topic is emphysema. Okay, so what we are going to learn about today?
Ma'am, khub slow awaaz hai to.
Hello.
Ma'am, awaaz khub kami hai to hai.
Ek minute. Oh. Aata hai to hai neat?
Wo ma'am.
Hello.
Hello.
Ma'am.
Ma'am, ye to ma'am.
Kami hai to hai ma'am, khubats.
Okay, aata?
Wo ala aata.
Aata hai to hai vastit?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh.
गुड। सो अपन सेशन स्टार्ट करूया। ओके सो आजचा टॉपिक आपला एम्फाइजिमा आहे। सो व्हाट वी आर गोना लर्न अबाउट टुडेज ऑब्जेक्टिव इज व्हाट इज एम्फाइजिमा, इन्सिडेंस ऑफ एम्फाइजिमा, कॉजेस ऑफ पॅथोफिजियोलॉजी, टाइप्स अँड क्लिनिकल फीचर्स, इन्व्हेस्टिगेशन, मॅनेजमेंट अँड कॉम्प्लिकेशन वी आर गोना लर्न अबाउट, वी विल लर्न टुमॉरो। ओके सो हे दोन पार्ट मध्ये डिवाइड केले आहे। सो आजचा पार्ट आपण क्लिनिकल फीचर्स पर्यंत बघणार आहोत, उद्या आपण इन्व्हेस्टिगेशन, कॉम्प्लिकेशन आणि मॅनेजमेंट बघणार आहोत एम्फायझिमाचे। ओके सो दिस इज द नॉर्मल अल्व्हिओलाय। हॅलो।
यस मॅम।
प्लीज मॅम प्लीज म्यूट करा सगळेजण स्वतःला। सो दिस इज द नॉर्मल अल्व्हिओलाय। ओके एम्फाइजिमा इज द वी कॅन से इट्स द एनलार्जमेंट ऑफ द एअर स्पेस अँड डिस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द अल्व्होलाय। सो वी विल सी ऍक्च्युअली डेफिनेशन ऑफ द एम्फाइजिमा, बट नॉर्मली वेन वी सी द हेल्दी अल्व्होलाय यू कॅन सी लाईक दिस स्ट्रक्चर, बट वेन दिस वी सी द अल्व्होलाय विथ द एम्फाइजिमा वी सी द डॅमेज अल्व्होलाय। ओके एज सीन इन द इमेज। सो वॉट इज एक्झॅक्टली एम्फाइजिमा? So by definition, emphysema is a chronic obstructive pulmonary disorder. See, emphysema is one of the type of COPD. So when we see the COPD, it's a very chronic disorder. Okay, so it's not acute. Like, abhi ek saal mein emphysema develop nahi hota hai. So it take a long duration, like maybe 10 years, 15 years to develop the emphysema type of the condition. So it's a chronic pulmonary disease. And it's preventable and treatable disease that make it difficult to empty air out of the lungs. Okay, so it's a condition that involves the damage of the wall of the air sac, that is the alveoli of the lung, and it make the person to difficult to breathe. So the breathlessness or the short of the breath, we can see the dyspnea. This is one of the characteristic clinical features of emphysema. So the people with emphysema, the air sac in the lung are damaged over the time, the inner wall of the air sac are weakened and rupture. So when the air sac, that is the air space of the alveoli, are weakened, and when that damaged or ruptured, it created the large air space inside the alveolar space, and it causes a destruction. See in the image, this is the normal, this is the bronchitis, in which see any emphysema, there is destruction of the wall. Our lung is a small sponge like structure, we all know about it. Okay, so in that lung, it lies within the chest and it protected by the rib cage. Our lung is specially protected by the rib cage. And when we see the lung, okay, so bronchioles terminated into the primary bronchioles, then tertiary bronchioles, secondary bronchioles, and then the alveoli. Okay, so the air sac, when inhaled, the oxygen is transported into the bloodstream, and carbon dioxide is transferred from the blood into the exhale, the breath. So lung is the primary organ which do the exchange of the carbon dioxide and the exchange of the oxygen. But when the alveoli is disrupted, or alveoli is enlarge of the air space and destruction of the alveoli, so it loses its elasticity. We will see in the pathophysiology. But when that elasticity is lost, there is difficulty in exchange of the airway, exchange of the oxygen and exchange of the carbon dioxide. So there is one term, when the in case of the emphysema patient, the air trapping. What is that? We will see. Awaaz aa rahi hai na barabar?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So this is the main definition of the emphysema. Okay, so emphysema is the enlargement of the air space and the destruction of the alveoli, in a simple language. Okay, so you always heard a term, two term, like very nearby, emphyema and the emphysema. So don't get confused between the emphyema and the emphysema. So ye maine janbujh ke dala, because many a time hum log confuse ho jate, we called as emphysema the emphyema and emphyema the emphysema. So main difference, when we called as the emphyema, so emphyema is the collection of the pus within a body cavity. Last time hum logon ne pleural effusion dekha tha, right? So one of the type of the pleural effusion is emphyema, not the emphysema. Okay, so emphyema is the collection of the pus within a that body cavity of the lung, whereas emphysema we can call as the abnormal and permanent enlargement of the acini or the alveoli, which is associated with the alveolar wall destruction, and there is no fibrosis. Okay, so main difference is emphyema is the collection of the pus, and emphysema is the enlargement of the alveoli and the or the destruction of the alveolus. Okay, so don't get confused between emphyema and the emphysema. These two terms are the different. So we see in India also, or in a overall the world, like 2 out of 1,000 people are suffered from the emphysema condition. So it more common in the men than the women because of the smoking. But nowadays also women are doing the smoking condition. So it can see in a woman also, it is largely seen that emphysema condition. Smoking is the one of the major cause to cause the emphysema. Okay, so it take over a period of time. It's not like ki agar abhi smoking start kar di and you develop a symptom of emphysema or any type within a 1 or 2 years. But you can see like symptoms when you start the smoking. You can see, may or may not be see the symptoms of smoking, like hazard, coughing or breathlessness, that bronchitis, acute bronchitis type of the symptoms you can see. And when you neglect that thing or neglect that symptoms, then it over a period of the time, it develop the condition like emphysema. So the causes of the emphysema, it caused because of the occupational exposure to maybe the chemical irritants, or any environmental pollutants, for example fume, coal or the dust. These are one of the cause of emphysema. Inherited genetic defect, majorly we can see smoking is one of the cause, and second common cause is the alpha 1 antitrypsin deficiency. What is that? We will see. Okay, so smoking is the most common cause of the emphysema, which result from the long term effect of the smoking cigarette. As I said, it's a chronic disorder, not the acute disorder. So about 90% of the emphysema caused because of the heavy smoker. सबको समझ रहा है यहां तक? हेलो.
यस मैम.
यस मैम.
ओके, आई एम लॉग. सो पैथोफिजियोलॉजी. So this is the normal alveoli. Okay, these are the elastic fiber of alveoli. These are the pulmonary veins which carry the oxygenated blood normally, and pulmonary artery which carries the deoxygenated blood. This is the alveolar sac. Okay, these are the bronchioles and the pores of Krohn's. So what is pores of Krohn's? Anyone, what is pores of Krohn's? Hello,
ma'am, wo adjacent alveoli jo rehte hain, jaise ek pura alveolar sac rehta hai. Hello,
ha,
to unke isme interconnection rehta hai.
Right, so it's a small communication between the adjacent pulmonary alveoli, and it provide a collateral pathway for the aeration. So jo airway hum log aeration lete, so this is the communication pathway, as corrected said by Rahul. Okay, then the alveolar duct. This is the alveoli, and these are the pulmonary capillary which surrounding the alveoli. Okay, so when the gases exchange occur, this is the capillary network. Okay, so capillary network around the alveolus. These are the alveoli. You can see, when you understand the normal, you can able to understand what is the abnormal pathophysiology of emphysema or any type of the condition. So please pay attention to this normal. Okay, so these are the blood cell in the capillary, RBC we can called as. So here oxygenated and deoxygenated bloods exchange occur. Okay, so alveoli are expand chamber of the epithelial tissue that are exchange the surface of the lung. Okay, there are about 150 million alveoli in each lung. Multiple alveoli usually share a common alveolar duct which created the alveolar sac. So this is the alveolar sac. Okay, and these are the elastic fiber. This is very important, the smooth fibers, smooth muscle, sorry, and the elastic fibers. Okay, so this elastic fiber, in which we can see the antiprotease and protease balance. Okay, so this is balance is very important in any type of any lung tissue. Okay, in our body these type antiprotease and protease balanced are always in a balanced condition. Okay, so what happen in emphysema? So in emphysema, the airway of the healthy lung which have a elastic property, okay, these are the elastic property. Okay, they lost this elastic property due to the smoking or due to any type of the pollutant air, we can called as. Okay, so the airway of the healthy lung that when have a elastic property, so when you breathe in, each air sac filled up with the air, and when you breathe out, the air sac deflect and air goes out. So imagine a balloon or that spongy ball. So when you squeeze it, okay, so when you squeeze it, the air goes out, and when you deflect that, so air goes in. Okay, this same function occur in our alveoli. So when you continuously exposure to noxious substance like air pollutant or smoking, there is increases the inflammatory response. So inflammation occur. कभी भी कुछ भी होता है तो first condition occur is the inflammatory response. Okay, so when the inflammation occur, even in the smoking or any type of the air pollutant, when we called as a noxious substances, not like a dust particle, like in a chemical particle or in a smoking, the toxins are antioxidant toxins. Okay, so these are very hazardous to our lung, to our body. So this antioxidant toxins causes a inflammatory response and generated the, it releases the inflammatory mediator like interleukin 6, interleukin 8, interleukin 1 or interleukin alpha also. So when previously we see antiprotease and the protease balanced, okay, so when these inflammatory response occur, there is neutrophil production increase, and when neutrophil production increase in the alveoli, they increases the protease. Okay, so this balanced, jo balance pehle tha antiprotease and the protease ke beech mein, wo balance rehta nahi hai. Okay, so it causes a destruction of the wall of the alveoli. Even when we see the alpha 1 antitrypsin deficiency, alpha 1 antitrypsin deficiency kya hai hum log aaj detail mein dekhenge, but what happen in alpha 1 antitrypsin, alpha 1 antitrypsin is one of the antiprotease. Okay, so it also like antiprotease decrease ho jata hai ya increase ho jata hai in alpha 1 antitrypsin deficiency mein, so basically it decrease ho jata hai in antiprotease mein, so it again causes a imbalance between the antiprotease and the protease, so ultimately it causes a destruction of the wall of the alveoli. Okay, so when there is destruction occur, so the alveolar membrane jo hum logon ne image mein dekhi thi, that alveolar membrane surface start decrease and that lessen the area available for the gas exchange. So gas exchange ke liye wo area hi nahi rehta hai, and it causes a destruction of the pulmonary capillary. Okay, so when the alveolar wall are destroyed, so yahan tak capillary wall destruction ho gaya, so when the alveolar wall are destroyed, the lung loses their capacity to recoil. Elastic fiber jo rehta hai, it is primary for the recoil or the air exchange, for the air exchange. But when that jab elastic fiber hi lose ho raha hai, so it lose their capacity to recoil and air become trapped in the lung and it destroy the lung tissue, resulting in the alveolar collapse. And when there is constantly having a extra air in the lung and the extra effort needed to breathe, person in resulting in person feeling the shortness of the breath. So ultimately it causes a dyspnea person, because dyspnea in person, because it destruction of the alveolar space, alveolar wall and alveolus. So when we see in shortly, when then smoking of the air pollutant and the genetic predisposition occur, it primarily causes the inflammation cell release, which releases the inflammatory mediator. Whereas congenital alpha 1 antitrypsin deficiency causes an imbalance between protease and the antiprotease. It also causes the oxidative stress, which increases the apoptosis and the senescence. It's an irreversible process, okay, apoptosis and the senescence, and it ultimately causes the alveolar wall destruction. So when we imagine a person, smoking person, okay, like when a person, koi imagine karo person jo bahut long time se smoking kar raha hai, okay, primary when he start smoking or when he start the smoking, there may be the healthy lungs, there is healthy alveoli. Okay, when this harmful particles trapped in the alveoli, there is inflammatory response trigger. ओके एंड देयर इंफ्लामेटरी केमिकल्स, इंफ्लामेटरी रिस्पॉन्स लाइक रिलीज ऑफ इंटरल्यूकिन 1, इंटरल्यूकिन 2, इंटरल्यूकिन 6 जनरली, एंड दिस कॉजेस अ लार्ज एयर कैपेसिटी लाइंड विद अ कार्बन डिपॉजिट फॉर्म, एंड देयर इज कॉजेस ऑफ द एम्फाइजीमा. सो मेन डिफरेंस वी कैन सी बिटवीन द ब्रोंकियल इंफ्लामेशन and the emphysema, it's very important because you will see inflammation har isme hota hai, even asthma ke condition mein hota hai, bronchitis ki condition mein hota hai, pleural effusion ki condition mein hota hai, har respiratory ke condition mein hota hai. But what the main difference between the these chronic bronchitis and the emphysema, when we see the chronic bronchitis there is irritation and the inflammation, okay, we can see the bronchial edema, hypersecretion of the mucus, chronic cough or the bronchospasm, which may, if not treated, they cause the airway obstruction, air trapping, dyspnea and the frequent infection, okay. Whereas here the important is there is breakdown of the elastin in connective tissue of the lung. In chronic bronchitis there is not destruction of the elastin, okay, at least not for the initial stage. If these go into the repeatedly infection, they may land up into the emphysema condition, but generally it not. So there is breakdown of the elastin in the connective tissue of the lung and there is destruction of the alveolar septi, airway instability, and since it causes the airway obstruction, air trapping, dyspnea, frequent infection and causes a symptoms like this, dyspnea, cough, hypoxema, hypoventilation. So this is the pathophysiology of the emphysema. समझ में आ रहा है? कंप्लीटली या
मैम विल यू प्लीज रिपीट व्हाट इज द कनेक्शन बिटवीन अल्फा 1 एंटीट्रिप्सिनोजेन एंड प्रोटीज एंटीप्रोटीज.
या या डेफिनेटली वो मैं आगे भी पढ़ाने वाली हूँ, पर यहाँ तक समझ में आया है?
हाँ या मैम.
ओके सो ही आस्क्ड अबाउट द अल्फा 1 एंटीट्रिप्सिन डेफिशिएंसी. ओके सो व्हाट इज अल्फा 1 एंटीट्रिप्सिन deficiency? So it's a autosomal recessive condition, okay, it inherited condition which rises the risk for the lung and as well as the liver disease. So alpha 1 antitrypsin is not only a lung disorder, it also the liver disorder, okay. So generally it's when we called as alpha 1 antitrypsin is a protein, okay, it's a antiprotease, but it's a protein which protect the lung and the liver. Liver actually generate the alpha 1 antitrypsin and it protect the lung. So in normally in all of us there is a presence of alpha 1 antitrypsin, okay. There when we called as the deficiency, when there is mutation of the SERPIN1 gene which located in the long arm of the chromosomal 14. So in many people it's very rare, but some people we can see there is chromosomal abnormality where there is deficiency of the alpha 1 antitrypsin, okay. So if the alpha 1 antitrypsin proteins aren't the right shape, they get stuck in the liver cell and they can't reach to the lung, okay. So agar iski deficiency ho, so it trapped in the liver only, so it will not go to the lung and it will not protect the our it will stuck in the liver and it will not go to the lung or it will not protect the lung. So when we see the patient with the alpha 1 antitrypsin deficiency, it has enhanced chance to develop the emphysema, okay. Or ye condition aisi hai ki it will not like located in a early stage, so early stage mein ye detect hi nahi hota hai, so it take a long duration, that's why it's called as the chronic. So it take very long duration, like 10 to 15 years or maybe 20 years to develop. So as I earlier said, elastin is a major constituent of the alveolar wall, okay. So the interesting elastic activity resulting in the degeneration of the elastin and is kept under the check of the alpha 1 antitrypsin, okay. In smoker condition also there is decrease in the level of the alpha 1 antitrypsin, okay, and even increases the elastic activity. Therefore this imbalance is occur mostly cause the alveolar wall destruction, see in the image, okay. So alpha 1 antitrypsin it generated in the liver. It's one of the protein, anti-protease. Okay, so it keep the balance between the protease and the anti-protease. Okay, so this alpha 1 antitrypsin coat the lung, protecting them from the neutrophils elastin. Okay, in a blood vessels. Okay, this is our white blood vessels, neutrophils. So neutrophil elastase produces by the white blood cells to break down the harmful bacteria and potentially damage to the lung if exposed. Okay, what happened in alpha 1 antitrypsin? So it synthesizes in the liver and secreted into the bloodstream to inhibit the neutrophil elastase. You all are getting. So it secreted into the bloodstream to inhibit the neutrophil elastin. So agar ye rahega hi nahi, so how they will inhibit the neutrophil elastase? So there is increased production of the neutrophil elastase. So when there is increased production of the neutrophil elastase, it automatically hamper the alveoli. It decreases the elastic recoil of the alveolar wall, and there is destruction of the alveolus. Look, so antitrypsin, there is deficiency of alpha 1 antitrypsin. So lung back, alpha 1 antitrypsin coating leaving them open to damage the neutrophil elastin. So here in a normal case, it coat the lung and protecting them from the neutrophil. Okay, but if there is a deficiency, it ultimately damage the lung, and it also not go to the bloodstream. So there, if there is deficiency, or generally the deficiency, it trapped in the liver and causes the liver damage. Okay, when there is a deficiency, when there is a normal, it inhibit the neutrophil elastase. But if there is a deficiency, it's not able to inhibit neutrophil elastase. Okay, and it causes the lung damage. Samjha? Everyone understood about what is the role of alpha 1 antitrypsin?
Man, means if neutrophil elastase go to the near alveoli, so it will damage the elasticity, right?
Yes.
मतलब ये neutrophil elastase अच्छा नहीं है.
Yes. Look here in the when okay दो जो inflammatory mediator released होते हैं. Okay, अगर इसमें अल्फा वन एंटीट्रिप्सिन की पोटेंसी बराबर रहे, ओके, सो इट्स नॉट डेफिशिएंसी अगर ये नॉर्मल कंडीशन में रहे, सो इट प्रोटेक्ट द लंग, ओके, अल्फा वन एंटीट्रिप्सिन प्रोटीन करता है, प्रोटेक्ट करता है, सो प्रोटीएज एंड एंटी प्रोटीएज का जो बैलेंस रहता है वो बराबर रहता है. सो वेन दैट बैलेंस इज, अगर ये बैलेंस बराबर है, ओके, इलास्टिक फाइबर का बैलेंस बराबर है, सो इट ऑटोमेटिकली प्रोटेक्ट द होल लंग. ओके, बट इफ दैट बैलेंस इज हैम्पर्ड, इट बैलेंस किसके वजह से हैम्पर्ड हो सकता है? आइदर बिकॉज ऑफ इन्फ्लामेटरी मीडिएटर्स. ओके, ये जो इन्फ्लामेटरी मीडिएटर्स है वो न्यूट्रोफिल प्रोडक्शन इंक्रीज कर देते हैं. ओके, सो देयर इज इंक्रीज प्रोटीएज, सो ये बैलेंस बिगड़ जाता है. और आइदर अल्फा वन एंटीट्रिप्सिन अगर डेफिशिएंसी हो गई, सो इट ऑल्सो इंक्रीजेज द न्यूट्रोफिल प्रोडक्शन. ओके, क्योंकि अल्फा वन एंटीट्रिप्सिन डिफिशियंसी है तो वो लीवर से प्रोडक्ट ही नहीं होगा और वो लंग को प्रोटेक्ट ही नहीं करेगा. सो इन द इमेज यू कैन सी, सो जब यहाँ पे वो इनहिबिट कर रहा है न्यूट्रोफिल इलास्टेज को, ओके, अगर है ही नहीं तो वो न्यूट्रोफिल इलास्टेज को इनहिबिट ही नहीं करेगा, राइट? सो इट अल्टीमेट, यस, सो इट अल्टीमेटली डैमेज द लंग. Yes, it ultimately go and damage. So it not only damage the lung, it also damages the liver also when this deficiency occur. So how? Look, so in the disease of the alpha 1 antitrypsin, if they cannot go to the bloodstream, so it accumulate in the liver and causes the liver damage. So jaundice, cirrhosis, or increased risk of the liver cancer also increase because of deficiency of alpha 1 antitrypsin. And if this is not going to the bloodstream, it is not going to the lung, so automatically it will not protect the lung, so it free of attack the lung and causes the lung disease called as COPD, emphysema, chronic bronchitis, etc. Get it?
Yes, ma'am.
So these alpha 1 antitrypsin protease is very important. सो इट्स वन ऑफ द प्रोटीन विच सिक्रीटेड बाय द लीवर एंड इट प्रोटेक्ट द लीवर एंड द प्रोटेक्ट द लंग ऑल्सो. सबको समझाए बराबर से? नहीं समझाए तो पूछो. इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस मैकेनिज्म. सबको समझाए?
यस मैम.
पक्का सबको समझाया अच्छे से? आगे बढ़े फिर.
यस मैम.
ओके. सो दिस इज द पैथोफिजियोलॉजी ऑफ द एम्फाइजिमा. देर आर द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ द एम्फाइजिमा. ओके. देर आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स. सो व्हेन वी कॉल्ड एज द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ द एम्फाइजिमा, इट डन अकॉर्डिंग टू द साइट ऑफ द डैमेज. ओके. सो देर आर मेनली फोर टाइप ऑफ द क्लासिफिकेशन: सेंट्रियासिनार, पैनासिनार, पैरासेप्टल and the irregular emphysema. So, classification. Okay, आवाज आ रही है ना मेरी? Hello.
Yes,
yes ma'am.
Okay, good. So classification of the emphysema. So that classification done according to the site of the damage. For example, alveoli ka kaun sa site damage hai, uske accordingly inhone classification ki hai and they termed that. Okay. So for example, agar distal part of the alveoli are damaged, so they named as a different. So that name is done according to the site of the damage. So there are the sentriacinar emphysema, पैनासिनार एम्फाइजिमा, पैरासिप्टल एम्फाइजिमा एंड इरेगुलर एम्फाइजिमा. ओके. सो व्हाट इज सेंट्रियासिनार एम्फाइजिमा? सो इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज द सेंट्रीलोब्यूलर एम्फाइजिमा. ओके. सो इट इन्वॉल्व द रेस्पिरेटरी ब्रोंकियोल्स बट इट स्पेयर द डिस्टल पार्ट. सो इन अ डिस्टल पार्ट, यू सी इन द इमेज, द डिस्टल पार्ट इज अनअफेक्टेड बट वेयर एज the respiratory bronchioles is affected. Okay. So it generally affect the alveoli and the airway in the central acinar and destroying the alveoli in the wall of the respiratory bronchioles and the alveolar duct. Pathophysiology are the same, but only it affected the respiratory bronchioles and not on the distal part. So it spares the distal part. So in the sentriacinar emphysema, there is dilation of the respiratory bronchioles. Generally, upper lobe is severely involved. Okay, then the lower lobe, and it may coexist with the chronic bronchitis. Okay, so as I earlier said, it is not the condition which develop like 1 or 2 years. It take a time. So maybe first is the chronic bronchitis develop and one of the complication of the chronic bronchitis is emphysema. हम लोगों ने बहुत सारे condition देखे हैं जिसमें emphysema is one of the complication. Even in the pneumonia condition, emphysema is one of the complication of pneumonia. So it can coexist with any other type of morbidity. So it can coexist with the chronic bronchitis. So occur with the damage to the lung tissue around the respiratory bronchioles while sparing the distal alveoli and in associated with the long standing cigarette smoking. So one of the most major cause is the cigarette smoking. Second type of the emphysema is the panacinar. It also called as the panlobular emphysema. So what is that? So it uniformly involves the entire respiratory acinus, so from respiratory bronchioles to the alveoli. Okay, so these involves the terminal bronchioles, even the distal part. So it affect the alveolar duct, alveoli, respiratory bronchi. So it occur more commonly in the lower lobe, especially to the basal segment एंड द एंटीरियर मार्जिन ऑफ द लंग. सो जनरली टैनस इन आर एम्फाइजिमा ऑब्जर्व इन द पेशेंट हु हैव अ अल्फा वन एंटीट्रिप्सिन डिफिशियंसी. थर्ड इज द पैरासिप्टल एम्फाइजिमा. सो व्हाट इज पैरासिप्टल? सो इट इज नोन एज द डिस्टल एसिनर एम्फाइजिमा. सो इट अफेक्ट द अल्वुलर डक्ट एंड द अल्वुलाई बट एट अ डिस्टल पार्ट. ओके, सो इट अफेक्टेड द डिस्टल पार्ट ऑफ द अल्वुलाई. इट कॉल्ड एज द पैरासिप्टल. सो इट रेफर टू अ मॉर्फोलॉजिकल सब टाइप ऑफ द पल्मोनरी एम्फाइजिमा which located adjacent to the pleura and septal line with a peripheral distribution within a secondary pulmonary lobule. So it enlarge in the distal part of the racina but proximal part is normal. So these the proximal part, whereas the terminal bronchioles or the respiratory bronchioles are, you can see it's a normal, but there is a presence of destruction of the distal part of the alveoli. Okay, which we called as the paraseptum. So it involves the dilatation of the distal airway structure, alveolar duct and the alveolar sac. Fourth is the irregular emphysema. So irregular emphysema, the name suggests, irregularly involve the all the part of the alveoli. So it also called as commonly parasitrachal emphysema. So as I said, irregular involvement of the acina. So emphysematous changes adjacent to the area of the pulmonary scaring, and it common around the scar tissue. So you can see in this image, septal ka ek part chhod diya hai, baki dusre part mein involved hai. Yahan pe bhi respiratory bronchioles ka ye part chhod ke baki sare part mein involved hai. So it, that's why it's called as the irregular emphysema. So when we see the morphology of the emphysema, these are the four types, okay? So when we see the morphology of the emphysema, we see the lungs are over inflamed. So these features, then the other type is more appreciated in Tanasena type, in which the over inflamed lung may be cover the heart anteriorly. Whereas in Centriacena type, the changes may be more subtle and scattered small cystic space among the normal lung tissue. Okay, what that scattered space, it may look the blackish due to accumulation of the carbon particle within them. That's why we called as the air trap. So in Pan-Acina type of the air filled spaces are more prominent and diffuse. In severe cases, these may be large air space forming a bullet. So imagine that ball, jo maine pehle aapko bola tha na, that spongy ball. So वो स्पॉन्ज बॉल जब हम लोग हाथ में पकड़ते हैं एंड जब हम लोग वो प्रेस करते हैं, स्क्वीज करते हैं, ओके, सो जब स्क्वीज करने के बाद हम लोगों को ज्यादा प्रेशर नहीं देना पड़ता, इट ऑटोमेटिकली एक्सपांड एंड ऑटोमेटिकली वो नॉर्मल शेप में आ जाता है, राइट? बट क्यों ऐसा होता है? बिकॉज मे बी दैट इलास्टिक प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ दैट बॉल. इमेजिन सेम विथ अल्वोलाय. ओके, जब हम लोग ब्रीथ इन करते हैं, ओके, सो ब्रीदिंग जब करते हैं, ब्रीदिंग करने के बाद जो इलास्टिक प्रॉपर्टी रहती है हमारे अल्वोलाई की, ओके, वो ऑक्सीजन अंदर लेती है एंड जब हम लोग ब्रीद आउट करते हैं, जब डिफ्लेक्ट करते हैं वो बॉल को, ओके, सो वो कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड बाहर छोड़ती है, राइट? अभी इमेजिन अगर इलास्टिक प्रॉपर्टी ही वो बॉल की खत्म हो गई है, ओके, सो जब इलास्टिक प्रॉपर्टी खत्म हो गई है तो जब हम लोग प्रेस करेंगे वो प्रॉपरली प्रेस नहीं होगा एंड इवन वो प्रॉपरली डिफ्लेक्ट नहीं होगा, राइट? यू आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग व्हाट आई एम सेइंग? हेलो,
यस मैम.
ओके, जब वो बॉल प्रॉपरली इन प्रॉपरली एक्सपांड नहीं होगा या प्रॉपरली डिफ्लेक्ट नहीं होगा, सो अगर उसके अंदर हम लोगों ने कुछ डाल दिया या फिर एयर डाल दी, सो वो एयर बाहर नहीं निकलेगी, राइट? सो वो एयर ट्रैप्ड हो जाएगी वहीं पे. सो सेम कंडीशन अगर इन एम्फाइजिमा, जो इलास्टिक प्रॉपर्टी है वो लॉस हो जाती है, उसकी वजह से जो एयर रहती है, दैट कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड मेनली, वो अंदर ही ट्रैप्ड हो जाता है, वो बाहर आ ही नहीं पाता है वो अल्वोलाय से. जब वो बाहर नहीं आ पाता है, so it accumulated in that air space only, okay, and it causes the symptoms like dyspnea, सो दैट्स व्हाई अर्लियर सेड स्टार्टिंग में जब मैंने बोला था कि इम्फाइजिमा का सबसे इम्पोर्टेंट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर है इज डिस्निया. सो एयर ट्रैपिंग इसको बोलते हैं, दैट दैट एयर इज ट्रैप्ड इन अल्वोलस ओनली. ओके, समझा है सबको कि एयर ट्रैपिंग क्या होता है और क्यों होता है?
यस मैम. मैम,
हाँ,
सो यू हैव मेंशन दैट डायलेशन ऑकर्स ओवर हियर, सो इज इट फॉर क्लियरिंग द एयर ट्रैपिंग और इज इट बिकॉज़ ऑफ लॉस ऑफ इलास्टिसिटी?
लुक, नॉर्मली क्या होता है,
द डायलेशन का मेन,
हाँ
हाँ हाँ
बोलो ना, क्या
डायलेशन का मेन कॉज क्या है यहाँ पे एम्फिजेमा में? इलास्टिसिटी लूज हुई तो वो तो पूरा कोलैप्स हो गया ना.
यस राइट. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इलास्टिसिटी लूज होने का कारण क्या रहता है? दैट प्रोटीएज एंड द एंटी प्रोटीएज का इम्बैलेंस. ओके, जो इम्बैलेंस हो जाता है उसकी वजह से ये हो जाता है. फिर एट नॉर्मली व्हेन यू इंस्पिरेट चेस्ट एक्सपांड हो जाता है. ओके, हम लोग एयर ब्रीद इन करते हैं एंड एक्सपीरेशन में क्या होता है, डिफ्लेक्ट हो जाता है. सो दैट इलास्टिक फाइबर ऑल्सो डिफ्लेक्ट. Right, but if it loses its control, if that elastic fibers lose it, so air trapped in that lung, in that alveolus only, that air space.
Yeah.
Okay, get it?
Ma'am, but I've got that. But dilatation kyun hota hai?
In dilatation,
size wagar increase ho jata hai.
राइट, सो दैट साइज इंक्रीज हो जाता है. ओके, दैट लेंथन इंक्रीज हो जाती है. ओके, सो व्हेन देयर इज डिस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ सम पार्ट. ओके, सो फॉर एग्जांपल इन पैरासेप्टल एम्फाइजिमा व्हेन वी कॉल्ड एज डिस्टल अल्वोला इज अफेक्टेड. ओके, ओनली डिस्टल अल्वोला, सो अल्वोलर डक्ट एंड अल्वोला इन्फेक्टेड हो जाता है. ओके, दैट एयर ट्रैपिंग अकर. ओके, ये जो कलर दिख रहा है दैट ब्लैकिश कलर, सो दैट कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड यहाँ पे ट्रैप्ड हो गया है. So when that air is trapped inside the alveolus, क्या हो जाएगा साइज का?
बढ़ जाएगा.
Right, भर जाएगा, वो साइज इंक्रीज हो जाएगा. ओके, एंड इट स्टार्टेड डिस्ट्रक्टिंग द अल्वोलर डक्ट, अल्वोलाय और द स्मॉल कैपिलरीज ऑल्सो. ओके, एंड अल्टीमेटली क्या हो जाएगा फिर अगर साइज इंक्रीज हो जाएगा तो?
अच्छा, तो इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ द ट्रैपिंग, द डायलेटेशन ऑफ़.
यस, सो इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ द ट्रैपिंग.
ठीक है, गॉट इट. ओके, नाउ गॉट इट.
सो दैट्स व्हाई दैट एयर ट्रैपिंग इज इम्पोर्टेंट इन द एम्फाइजिमा. जो एयर ट्रैपिंग होता है, इवन इन द मॉर्फोलॉजिकल स्टडी व्हेन दे कॉल्ड एज दैट स्कैटर्ड स्पेस मे लुक ब्लैकिश ड्यू टू अक्यूमुलेशन ऑफ द कार्बन पार्टिकल विद इन देम. सो देयर इज अक्यूमुलेशन, देयर इज अल्टीमेटली डायलेटेशन ऑफ द ब्रोंकियोल्स एंड ऑफ दैट स्पेस. ओके, हेलो,
हाँ मैम, ओके,
या,
हाँ ओके.
सो इवन इन द पैन एसिना टाइप द एयर फिल्ड स्पेसेस आर मोर प्रोमिनेंट एंड द डिफ्यूज एंड वेयर एज इन सीवियर केसेस देयर मे बी द लार्ज स्पेस फॉर्मिंग द बुले. सो बुलस एम्फाइजिमा मीन्स देयर इज द लार्ज बुलस, लाइक बुल टाइप जब हम लोग बोलते हैं. सो देयर इज इंक्रीज दैट स्पेस. So in microscopically we can see there is destruction of the acinar wall with the formation of the large space. The remaining alveolar wall are thin and there is no significant fibrosis. Okay, so these are the morphology and the microscopic stages. Clinical features bhi hum log kal dekhenge. Okay, yahan tak kisi ko confusion hai?
No ma'am.
सबको समझाए प्रॉपरली?
यस मैम.
किसी को कुछ भी कंफ्यूजन होगा तो अब भी पूछ लो. ये इमेज को हमें ध्यान में रखना. ओके, सो ये इमेज को ध्यान में रखोगे तो यू कैन एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड कि व्हाट इज एग्जैक्टली हैपन व्हेन द एम्फाइजिमा अकर्स.